Mike, let's start here. After the close Monday, we could get some big capital return plans. What are the numbers that you're looking for, sir?
Well, wow. This was the Fed stress test, and it used to be the Super Bowl of banking, and now it's like a preseason game. It was boring, but you know what? Boring is beautiful for banks. The Fed threw the kitchen sink at the banks with the stress test. The banks passed with flying colors. As you mentioned, Monday at 4:30 p.m., we expect a flurry of press releases that announces increases in dividends and buybacks, and we ultimately expect capital return to double versus the prior year, and that should lead to an all-in yield. So that's the dividend yield plus buybacks. That's better than what it is for even junk bonds. So there's a lot of value with banks, and we think that will draw in new investors, quants, dividend funds, dividend growth funds. So ultimately what this means is redemption for the banks. Remember during the pandemic, banks were going to fail. They were going to cut the dividend. Now you have dividend increases and a bevy of banks with buyback increases, you know, after Monday. So this is very good news for banks. And I would say thank you, regulators, after the global financial crisis worked. And now banks and their investors should be able to reap the benefits.
So, Mike, why are we not seeing more of a reaction in markets?
You know, people have been skeptical about banks for the past year. As you know, we upgraded a few of the large banks in the middle of the crisis. They didn't trust the resiliency of the banks, right? It was kind of the memory from the global financial crisis. It was still front and center. And it's like, okay, if something goes wrong, banks are going to get hurt. And that was the farthest from the truth. If anything, you know, the more of the risk has been outside of the banking industry. So just like there's been skepticism too much over the past year, there's still skepticism. But connect the dots. I mean, banks pass the Fed stress test. Monday at 4:30 p.m., you get the announcements. Then you get the increases.
No, Mike, hold on a second. I'm sorry. I don't think I hear from a lot of people that they're worried about some sort of systemic risk from the banks. I hear the fact that the yield curve is flattening, that this has been priced in. I mean, are you saying that it's not that people are still worried about systemic risk?
No, I think that's passed. That's what happened over the last 6 to 12 months. But now people are like, well, we know the dividends are coming, but we don't really care that much. But I think they should care, because if you look at the dividend yield adjusted for buyback should be about 8%. Compared to the 10-year yield of under 2%, that gap is one of the widest in history. Where can you get an 8% yield globally? And in fact, that's 300 basis points above the junk bond yield. So I think people are just cynical and skeptical about the sustainability of banks' cap returns, the sustainability of earnings. And Lisa, you raise a great point. The flatter yield curve is on people's minds. But look what just happened last week. The Fed said now it's likely to have two increases in the Fed funds rate in 2023, and banks benefit twice as much from increases in short-term rates as they do from increases in long-term rates.
Mike, you're famous for your calls coming on the program and saying banks aren't financials. Banks are just tech companies. Despite all of the buybacks and dividends, are they investing enough to keep up with big tech?
Well, the largest banks certainly are. I mean, some of the best fintech players on the planet are Bank of America and JP Morgan. You have tens of millions of customers. And this is going from digital interactions to digital relationships. They're not just touching customers through one point, but through multiple points. And they continue to invest, and they continue to gain customers. And both Bank of America, which is our number one pick, and J.P. Morgan grew deposits over the past year equal to the sixth largest bank. And that was organic growth. And a lot of that is aided through digital banking.